us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord.
Heavenly Father.
Word from the Lord. Just one word from the Lord. And cause the sun to shine and give us peace.
Brothers right here that will go out on the world wide web.
Yes, Lord, in Jesus' name.
Anything I have to say doesn't mean anything. It don't mean a hill of beans to me, in my opinion.
Yes, Lord.
I want people to know what you would say through me, Father.
Yes, Lord,
and just use me as your instrument, Father.
Yes,
as a vessel, as a conduit. That I might help somebody somewhere along the way.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name, I ask.
Jesus' name. Amen.
Hello. Who is it?
How is everybody tonight?
All right.
Amen.
We're talking about hope. I really struggled with this. Last Sunday morning, as I sat right over there, I'd already had a passage laid on my heart, I felt for hope. And lo and behold, toward the end of my pastor's sermon, he used that passage. I was going to abandon it, but I was talked out of it. And through the week, I really had a lot of affirmation that God still had something he wanted to say through me through this. I want to read it first thing right off the bat. It's a beautiful passage, as I confessed last Sunday, or Friday. You'll hear a lot out of me that it's one of my favorite passages. I love the Word of God. I love how it flows. It's a book that's alive. No other book can say that. And most of the passages in it just lift me up. And this is one of them that really, really lifts me up. We'll be in Psalms 37, 23 through 25. I'm going to read the NIV version of it. If the Lord delights in a man's way, he makes his steps firm. Though he stumble, he will not fall, for the Lord upholds him with his hand. I was young, and now I'm old. Yet I have never seen the righteous forsaken or the children begging bread. The title of mine is The Stimulus Package of Hope. Nowadays, especially the last 6 months, we've had a lot of things go on in our country. Yeah. It's an exciting time, a time of change. But it's also, on the flip side of that coin, there's a lot of bad things going on in our country too. And I'm not going to get off into anything moral that's going on, even though in schools we know and in society there's a lot of things going on as Christians we don't agree with. But I'm talking about our financial situation. We're talking recession, maybe even depression, jobs. I read on the internet today the states that were dropping a percentage point a month sometimes, unemployment. Our car industry looks like it's falling on its face.
Yes.
The steel industry has been going downhill for years. And then we as Americans have maybe seen a way of life wither away that we thought we would always have. There's a lot of things been said in the last few months about what we can do about it. A lot of men and women have made promises that they can do something about it. But I'm going to use the thesis of my message that true hope can only come from God.
All right. I think
this passage brings true that hope. Out.
True hope.
In 23, it says, if the Lord delights in a man's way, he makes his step. That means God is guiding your path. That'd be, you know, my 3 points would be path, protection, and provision.
All right.
I can remember when I was fishing tournaments. Lots of time, well, all the time on a tournament launch, you'd be up 3 o'clock in the morning getting ready. I mean, you're there before daylight, and right at daylight they start launching you. Well, at the boat ramp, especially if you fall a cove, there's a jillion boats there trying to get in, and I didn't want to launch at you fall a cove. I'm staying completely across the lake. So what I did the day before, I get in you fall a cove, turn my GPS on, I drive back in a good safe route to where I'm staying, where I'm going to dock my boat that night, all right? And then I mark my trail. So what I do the next morning in the dark, I travel across there in the dark watching my GPS and that trail.
Mm-hmm.
As long as I stay on that trail, a satellite's tracking me. Mm. I'm not going to hit a stump. Mm. I'm not going to hit a sandbar. I'm not going to hit a rock. Mm. As long as I stay on that path, I'm going to go right there to Eufaulico. I'm not going to have all the hassle of trying to find a place to lodge. That path makes it easy on me that morning.
Yeah,
all right,
yeah,
when you're all, man, if you think I get nervous, when I was fishing tournaments, I'd be so wrapped up, tired, and scared, and the whole nine yards. But as long as I stayed on that path, I didn't have any worries about getting over there to lunch.
Hmm,
What's he saying in 23? If the Lord delights in your way, watch him. He's that path. It doesn't matter that we're talking recession. It doesn't matter that we're talking jobless. I can tell you a story that happened this week.
Yes.
In 24 hours, a situation that I thought was going to be dire, boom, solved. God did it. Nobody else. It's that path. Second point, protection.
Protection.
Though he may stumble, he will not fall, for the Lord upholds him with his hand. I'm going to kind of tie the last two points together because the other is provision.
Okay.
I was young once and now I'm old and I've never seen the righteous forsaken or his children begging bread. I heard a guy say the other day at work, and I think he's pretty close to right. The Democrats tell you that they're going to look after you and take care of you, and the Republicans try to tell you you're scared and they're going to protect you. Well, I'm telling you, neither one is the truth. They may tell you that, but neither one is the truth. God will protect you, and God will feed you, period. We got the Word of God saying it right here, and I believe that settles it. And we get back to things in our lives. If we think about when we're on that path, when we're just going that straight path, focusing on God, he's our GPS.
We're not hitting
any sandbars. We're not running up on a log. We're not knocking the skag out of our boat or anything
We've got
that safe path over there. We're protected, and that's our provision. Think about that.
Amen.
If we keep our eye on him.
Yes.
God's going to provide us a job.
Mm.
It says, and I believe the Word of God is 100% infallible and true, that I've never seen the righteous forsaken or their young begging bread. Do you think you're going to be the first? It's never happened. That means it never will happen. I'm not going to be the first one. You're not going to be the first one. When those times get tough, and they do, we're all just working people here.
Most of the time,
I don't have two nickels to rub together, and I don't care anymore. I used to as a young man, but I don't care anymore. I don't care anymore. Because God is going to give me what I need.
Not what I want,
I need. He's going to give me. And I have no qualms about it.
Yes.
I can honestly say for the first time in my life this week, the first time a situation crept up and I just dropped it and said, God, it's yours. I'm not going to worry about it this time. I had such a peace. I haven't had a peace like that. I don't know that I ever had a peace like that in such a stressful situation. And in 24 hours, it was 24 hours, it was fixed.
He knew it.
Another little deal come up that would have generally put me in a backspin too. And it took a few more days. I thought it was going to be a real expensive. I'll tell you what it was. My wife's car was broke down and my back's real bad. I'm not able to work on stuff like I once did. And I was wondering, you know, how we're going to do this and that. Guy looked at it today, fixed it for $65.
Amen.
I wouldn't get my jeans dirty for $65 anymore. I hate to say that. I mean, is that God?
Yes, it is.
I'm telling you, he takes care of his own.
Yes, he does. It says it right here, and I believe it.
I appreciate y'all.
Amen.
I do, each and every one of you.
Yes, Lord.
And I love you. Thank you very much.
Amen.
Another calm on the sea. But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.